I, Mrs. Veena Sunil Patki, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, welcome you for this session. At the end of this session, students can explain construction, types, and working of single-phase induction motor. So first, let us see about the types of single-phase induction motors. Single-phase induction motors has the basically four types. Split-phase motors, it has again four types: resistance start motor, capacitor start motor, permanent split capacitor motor, two value capacitor motors, then shaded pole induction motor, reluctance start induction motor, and repulsion start induction motor. Again, the commutator type single phase motors: repulsion motor, repulsion induction motor, AC series motor, universal motor, and then single phase synchronous motor, which rotates with synchronous speed, that is reluctance motor, hysteresis motor, and subsynchronous motors. There are some drawbacks of single phase induction motors: lack of starting torque, reduced power factor, low efficiency, speed control is very difficult for these single phase motors, and due to poor starting torque cannot be used for applications which required very high starting torque. So these are the drawbacks of single phase motors. Why single phase induction motor is not self-starting? The stator of single phase induction motor is wound with single phase winding, and when the stator is fed with single phase supply, it produces alternating flux. That alternating flux acting on squirrel cage rotor cannot produce rotation. That rotation only is due to revolving flux, and that's why the single phase induction motors are not self-starting. So you can see in this diagram, clockwise torque and anti-clockwise torque is created on the rotor due to positive cycle and negative cycle. So resultant torque will be zero, because here when we calculate the anti-clockwise torque and clockwise torque, due to these anti-clockwise and clockwise torque, rotor only vibrates. So if we give some mechanical force to that rotor, rotor will rotate in that direction and motor runs. But every time we have to apply the mechanical force on that rotor. That's why we can say that the single phase motors are not self-started. So let us discuss about the construction of single phase induction motor. Basically, this motor contains stator and rotor. So you can see here, these are the stator slots. In that, the stator winding is placed. So stator is made up of the laminations. This is the shaft. This is the air gap in between stator and rotor. This is the rotor, and the rotor laminations are used to reduce the eddy current losses. And you can see here, the rotor slots are there in which the winding is placed. Now let us discuss about this in detail. So you can see in this diagram, this is the stator part, this is the rotor part, this is the outer frame of the motor, and motor shaft is there. So you can see in this diagram, the two windings are placed. This is the main winding, and here this is the starting winding. So two windings are there. To make the single phase induction motor self-started, we have to convert that motor into two phase motors. So that's why here the two windings are placed, and here the slots are present. In that slots, the main winding and starting windings both are placed. This is the rotor. Now let us see about the stator and rotor in detail. So this is the stator part. You can see here the winding is placed and the stator has the laminated iron core with two windings. One is the main winding and another is the auxiliary or starting winding. So which have the 90 degree phase shift, and due to that two windings, the rotating magnetic flux is created and we can make the single phase induction motor self-started. So you can see here these are the slots and iron core is there, and here the winding is placed in that slots and the stator slots are laminated. If we use the laminated core, we can reduce the eddy current losses. Now let us see about the rotor. Squirrel cage rotor has the laminated core with slots. So here the aluminium bars are placed in that slots. Laminated iron core is there. Here the fan blades are there. This is the shaft and the aluminium ring is provided at the end of this rotor. Due to that, all these conductors, all these aluminium bars are connected together to make the closed path on the rotor. These end rings or the aluminium rings are provided. So why the rotor slots are skewed? So you can see here these rotor slots have some inclination with this shaft. These slots are not parallel with this shaft. You can see some inclination is provided. So why rotor slots are skewed? To reduce locking tendency of the rotor and to make motor run quietly by reducing the magnetic hum, because it will create some noise in the motor. That is called as the magnetic hum. Now, pause the video and think, what is the special feature of single phase induction motor? High starting torque, low starting torque, average starting torque, zero starting torque. So, what is the answer? Answer is zero starting torque. That's why we can say that the single phase induction motors are not self-started. So this is the special feature of the single phase induction motor. Single phase induction motors are not self-starting due to pulsating magnetic flux. To create the rotating magnetic flux, two coils are connected having 90 degree phase difference. The phase shift is achieved by resistance, inductor and capacitor. So according to starting methods, these are the types of single phase induction motors. Split phase motors. So here the two windings are provided. That winding are generally connected in parallel with each other, and the resistance start motor, one winding has the higher resistance than other. So main winding has the low resistance, or we can say the more inductive winding is there, and the starting winding has the high resistance as compared to main winding. So here the phase difference is created. So second is the capacitor start motor. So one capacitor is connected with the starting winding, and the phase difference is created due to capacitor. Third is the permanent split capacitor motor. So here permanently two capacitors are connected in series with the main winding and starting winding to create the high starting torque. We are going to connect the capacitor. So next is the two value capacitor motor. So to increase the power factor of the motor, we are going to use the capacitor in this single phase induction motor. And the shaded pole induction motor, the pole is divided into two parts which create the rotating fluxes in the motor, and we can make the single phase induction motor self started. So these are the types. Let us discuss all these types in next session. You can refer the books Electrical Engineering by B.L. Thareja, Principles of Electrical Machines by V.K. Mehta and Rohit Mehta. Thank you.